बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम क्लास सेवेंथ इट्स टाइम टू डू द चैप्टर नंबर फोर मैग्नेट्स एंड इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेट्स फ्रॉम द वर्कबुक वी हैव डन लास्ट टाइम दिस चैप्टर फ्रॉम द टेक्स्ट बुक मैग्नेट्स एंड इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेट्स एंड होप यू हैव क्लियर्ड मच इन दिस चैप्टर दैट वॉज अबाउट मैग्नेट्स अट्रैक्शन एंड रिपल्शन एंड मैग्नेटिक फील्ड theory of magnetism, quoting about magnetism, how to make a permanent magnet and what is electromagnetism and then using of electromagnets and also the where are the magnets present and magnetic card and how they can store data on magnetic cards. Now the first thing that you have to try to do that is to give the correct answer from page number 57 of your textbook and you have to tell whether the conditions are true and false after revising the chapter and just this one and now come for the magnets and electromagnets. Here you have to tell state whether the following statements are true and false. These all statements are from your textbook and they are related from your topics that we have covered. So magnetism is a force which can travel over very large distances. Is it true or false? Headphones use both permanent magnets and electromagnets. Is it true or false? So in this way you can do the question number 2, choose the correct option. Which shape is the magnetic field around a wire carrying an electric current? Which shape? Clear? Here a diagram is showing a bar magnet. Where are the poles of a magnet called N and S? Which poles of a magnet attracts N pole and repulse S pole? Which force? The diagram above the draw lines to show the magnetic field of a bar magnet. Which of these materials are magnetic? Underline the magnetic materials. Which materials are magnetic? You have to highlight. Is newspaper a magnetic material? No. Plastic cup? No. Steel nail? Yes, it is a magnetic material. So you have to draw a line below that. Brass handle? So you have to tell whether is it magnetic or not. A bar magnet drops the floor and breaks in its in halves. The two halves become complete magnet. Label the poles of new magnets. You have to give the labels of new magnet. Obviously it will become N and S. What will happen if two new magnets are moved closer together? What would happen if the magnets were broken into smaller and smaller pieces? Obviously they will remain the same magnets. Here are some words given, so you have to fill these blanks with the help of these given words. The diagram shows a wire passing through a piece of card. The wire is carrying an electric current. How would you show that a magnetic field is produced by current flowing in the wire? So you can read this experiment. You have to write the answer. Here the diagram is shown of a coil wire. Diagram B shows the coil of wire wrapped around an iron rod. Clear? Explain why the magnetic field is stronger around B than A. Why B strong than A? Because it has an iron rod. When the electricity passes through the iron rod, the copper wire that is coiled around the rod, that will also be magnetized and that will also become very stronger, so that this one is will become more stronger. So you have to write the answers about this one. After revising your chapter you will be more clear about these pages and you will be more clear for solving this.